Fishing in Lake Huron and Lake Michigan has changed radically in recent years. These changes are related to changes in the lakes themselves, and scientists are now trying to understand how salmon and trout are adapting their diet.
Some species like lake trout can feed on a wider variety of prey than specialized predators like Chinook salmon.
I mean, these fish are big, but not huge. But a few years back, they're probably just half.
Not much in there.
The average size of Chinook salmon on Lake Michigan has been bouncing up and down a lot in recent years. This is related to the fluctuations in abundance of alewife, which disappeared from Lake Huron in 2004.
Anglers still see schools of alewife, like this one, in harbor areas and offshore, but the total number of large alewife in offshore areas of Lake Michigan has been at or near all-time lows for the past several years. Open water prey like alewife have been struggling due to high predator numbers and ecosystem changes related to the invasion of quagga and zebra mussels. These mussels are eaten by another invasive species, the round goby. Gobies now provide an important source of food for some predator species. This has led biologists to believe it is important to collect more information on where and when all species of salmon, trout, and walleye are eating gobies, alewife, and other prey species in Lake Michigan and Huron. Anglers can support this by following these easy steps. Once you are back on land, measure each fish to the nearest quarter inch.
Would you like on that one? This one is 14 and a quarter.
The stomach is the most important part of this study.
That's the stomach, that's the intestine.
And can be collected easily, like so.
Gotta get way up in here and feel. There's the esophagus right here.
So pretty high in there.
Yep. Find and cut the esophagus, which leads into the stomach, and the intestine, which leads out of the stomach.
Feel it back.
Some fat and finger-like projections called pyloric cheekae may be removed along with the stomach.
It looks almost like a different organ.
Place the entire stomach and all contents in a bag.
The whole thing.
Be sure to include any regurgitated bait fish, if there are any in the mouth of your catch. Remember, to avoid bias, you should decide if you will be collecting stomachs before you head out for a day's fishing.
That's intestine.
You don't need to collect fish from every trip you take, but stomachs from 2 to 3 trips per month would be very helpful. Remove stomachs by cutting the esophagus and the intestine, being careful not to cut the bend in the thick-walled stomach. Do this for all the fish caught during your trip, or for all fish of a single species, if you do not have time to take stomachs for all species. Place each stomach in its own bag, along with a completed data tag. Keep stomachs on ice until they can be frozen, and freeze bag stomachs as soon as possible. There's often a freezer by the cleaning station. This one is also used for the Michigan DNR's head collection.
Snout collection, but you can also take the stomachs and put them in the freezer. But instead of just throwing them in the bottom here, tuck them over to the side and put them in the same freezer.
It's your resource. Be mindful of the role you can play to keep it thriving. Full instructions, data tags, and a list of drop sites for the Huron-Michigan diet study can be found at michigansea grant.org/diet.